Underwater. That's where I'll stay. Where if you need, you can really drink your troubles away. I'm a gun for hire, and this is our Archimedean dynasty, if you want to call it that way. When humanity went down, all the water in the world went above our heads. What a soggy life. Down here we have been relegated in what we call habitats. Because above water we made huge mistakes and caused a bit of a ruckus. We called it Third World War. Just a small difference from the previous two. It was nuclear. Radiation quickly took away every life form and every one of us not quick enough to decide that it was time to go underwater. Technology was there, but breathing had to be refined. I wouldn't know a single thing about that either way since I was born 5 centuries later. My name is Deadeye, sorry, Emerald Flint. I'm so used to people calling me by my mercenary avatar that I sometimes forget who am I, really. The forced vacation in the Shogunate concentration camps didn't help either way. 1 year of a life lost and it was the fault of a woman I can't help but love. Now I do dirty or clean jobs. It doesn't matter. Whomever manages to pay me well, I follow. Unless a good-looking woman is involved. Oh, I know. It's not something I should be proud of, and trust me, I'm not. The life we make here has removed almost any form of normalcy from our brains. Nobody is really normal like people on the surface were. A long time ago, if you're lucky, you're gonna have the intelligence to get a high-paying job. There you'll end up running the lives of many people under you. Maybe they will give you a good seabed funeral if you were nice enough to them when you were a gas breather like the rest of us. After a while, I realized there are more important things in life than drinking algae fermented synth oil. I found a dangerous threat to our very existence. A weird species, fusion of organic and not, we call them bions. Well, it would be more accurate to describe them as it. Because they don't think. A single entity thinks, and they all think the same. Ah, screw it. This is getting too confusing. I'm starting to regret dismissing synth oil so quickly. But I don't really like to wage war drunk. It makes sloppy work of me. Also, I don't wanna talk about how it all ended. It's something that maybe somebody else will tell you. I'm not in the mood for the grand finale. Maybe if I ever get nephews, I'll spill it all out. Anyway, it goes like this. I travel from station to station tackling all sorts of jobs from all walks of life. As long as the pay is bigger than my expenses, that is. In those places, be careful how you talk to some people. Trust me, because they might hold a grudge against you. A lot of people makes use of drugs down here. To make the smelly air go down better. You know how it is. Some did, but it changed them. So you gotta be careful. It may just happen that you hear of an interesting job proposal, but it might just never materialize if the interested party decides that they hate you. Not that you have to play the goon for everybody. Some people are better left alone to their own devices. Not all work is good work. That is still true even in Aqua. Yeah. That's what we have decided to call this place. Earth didn't sound right after a while. But I'm not complaining. I think Deadeye fits me after all. All I do is fight and I feel, no, not happy, but fulfilled every time I once again come into a friendly port and realize that, yes, I am, in fact, alive. Such a strange feeling, but also something I can't do without. Also, I love my ship. Well, loved. Until the other love of my life and my eternal rival destroyed it. My memory isn't faulty. That's how it went. But I wasn't unlucky in the end. I suppose I received all my other ships, for one reason or the other, for free. Just a matter of associating yourself with the right people, and I'm pretty good at understanding someone's pockets. The jobs are important because after all I've got to repair those babies often. Mercenary, if you remember. That also means always following the latest technological developments. Shielding, repairing androids, sound mufflers, torpedoes, waterproof guns of any kind, and more weapons of mass destruction for the modern man. Yeah, not really a science-inclined person, not me. But I'll make sure to check every dealer of that possible to find every single new plasma turret or power generator I can. After all, I pay people for my repairs, I'm ignorant that way, but I can shoot with one or two of my eyes closed. Oh, so that's where it came from. After all, I always keep my holo notes handy on what button to press to always remember how to navigate. I had to since I changed 5 ships in less than a year, and trust me on this one, buddy, they don't run the same at all. At least they didn't make me pay any fee to transfer any of my equipment, unless that kind of mail didn't arrive only because we were at war. I dread the day when I'll find out. Oh well, what the heck. I'm going away for a long time. I could tell you a thing or two about the kind of missions I had to encounter. You can do many things here. Escort people, transport goods, fight for a good cause, be ambushed because of old grudges that you brought upon yourself, but two are the situation I was always in at the end of the day. Lucky and unlucky. Lucky is when you have people helping you out with navigational points. Unlucky is when you're on your own. Because things look distinctive enough when you're near some sort of structure. Orientating yourself around that is as easy as having fun in Atacama City. I appreciate looking at the sights, even if I know these waters well. Seeing how things change or stay the same helps me greatly in this SOB of a line of work. Sorry, my sobriety spoke again. I really shouldn't let it. But when nothing's in sight, that is when I truly hate it. Not knowing where to go and what to do. I am forcefully reminded I'm in my ship and not freely navigating at my own leisure. I have to admit that I panic and constantly search for the way forward, and looking down at my sonar only helps if somebody else is in sight. Otherwise, I might even die on my own. I really loathe it when nothing is around me. I see those rays of light coming from above and it almost makes me want to go toward the eternal end. Knowing that radiation will make the ship enter a series of failures so structurally hard that a quick fiery death is the only ending to my story. The only one that I could accept too. Barring dying during an honorable battle, at least. Those are the words that I could see coming out of General Scock's mind. I wonder if he's alive, the old urchin. Nothing that bad has ever happened yet, outside of my worst nightmares. But every once in a while I see it reflected in the grey seabed. And then I ask myself how many people feel like they belong to water as strongly as I do. But the sounds of the oceans, the creaking of my ship, or even just a good port side shot brings me back to reality. Thanks to that I realize how much I love what little sound we get down here. Sure, I could turn on the radio and listen to whatever crank everybody's thinking, but I'm not suicidal. I'll let go of music until I can stand up on my own two legs. Only in one other occasion I concede myself to relax my proven bones and maybe, if my nightmares allow me, to get some sleep. On the ship it's better to maintain a certain level of concentration after all, until the sonar tells you that the autopilot is a viable option. Good invention. Could forget about that light up there. Too fast to really soak it in. My life up until now in a number? What is that? A new Clans Union game? Is there money to be made in it? Oh, what the hell. People might think that Deda is going on an ego trip, but I sincerely believe it's 9. Yes, a 9 out of 10. Let me use this metric. I did in school and it's easy to understand for me. Why so high? Did you hear how proud I am of what I do? There's a couple of regrets that keep me from being the best that I could achieve with what I have. Aside from the fact that most of it is really long work and pretty repetitive, I deprive myself of many joys. No more smiling, but I can't help being sarcastic. No more alcohol during travel. Not after my imprisonment. No more empty spaces. No more I have the capability to enjoy peace times. No more Hong Long, my most loved hater.